Are there on the left, Oscar De La Hoya on the right. When we come back, Alex and I will set this thing up for you. Don't go away.
Yeah, we didn't have to do that.
Okay, Dan, it's interesting to note that in a Ring magazine poll, boxing people were asked if you could have one young prospect, who would it be? But Oscar at the top of the list. That's sort of the fact that he's unlikely to gain 100 pounds and become a heavyweight. Oscar has an awful lot going for him. He's a loaded with boxing talent, but he's handsome, articulate, the only American gold medal winner last year's Olympics. He has already earned well over $1 million.
You want to? Why not?
Thanks very much, guys. We appreciate it. Why don't you not do that? Okay? Why don't you use your head and not do that?
Alex talks, and then I lead to the piece, right?
Okay.
They're waving their hands in front of the camera.
Yeah, it's, you like a program that goes well, huh?
Is he for real? Well, we just don't know. We can't know until he gets hit by a world-class puncher.
How long?
World-class puncher to see how he reacts. His opponent, Frank Tipping, he's not a bum. In fact, he's got a winning record, a solid record, and holds the North American 130-pound title. But he is not a puncher. And Dan, until Oscar gets tested, gets tested by someone with power. Let me see it when you got it. Until he gets tested by someone with power, we just have to be patient and wait before we confer greatness on him. Very good. Back to top. Hold that for a second for me, please. Hold this for me, too. 20 back.
This is a big break.
10 back.
And there is a look at Bruce Willis, who's ringside here in Lake Tahoe, getting ready for the Oscar De La Hoya face, for the fight, rather. And, Alex, let's move now to a couple of less recognizable faces at ringside, the two of us. Oscar De La Hoya, here is a young man who's really in rarefied air, you know, in expectations, in the money he's already making from endorsements. And people are saying this is the next Sugar Ray Leonard, and maybe even bigger.
Well, it was interesting to note that in a recent Ring magazine poll, boxing people were asked, if you could have one young prospect, who would it be? And they put Oscar at the top of the list. Outside of the fact that he's unlikely to gain 100 pounds and become a heavyweight, Oscar has an awful lot going for him. Not only is he loaded with boxing talent, he is a handsome, articulate kid. He's the only American gold medal winner at last year's Olympics. He has already earned well over $1 million in purses and endorsements before his first 10-round fight, which is today. And the question Dan poses is right. Is he for real? Well, we just don't know. We can't know until he gets hit by a world-class puncher to see how he reacts. His opponent, Frankie Avelar, is typical of Oscar's opponents to date. He is not a bum. He has a solid winning record. In fact, he holds the North American 130-pound title. But he is not a puncher. And Dan, until Oscar gets tested by someone with power, we just have to be patient and wait before we confer greatness on him.
Yeah, and it's, boy, but it looks like the total package, doesn't it?
Yeah, no, unlimited potential.
Really does.
And fun to watch.
You're right. And, you know, Alex, like all successful athletes, Oscar De La Hoya is an abundance of pride. And certainly that pride is understandable when you look at his accomplishments, and they are many. But it is his feelings, for his Hispanic heritage and his hometown that have really won him so many fans. Los Angeles, the city of angels. It conjures up images of the good life. Expensive homes, expensive cars. But there's another section of Los Angeles County, separated not so much by miles as by culture. East Los Angeles is home to a large Latino population. And though it has its share of gang and drug problems, it's also an area rich in its sense of self, in its sense of the community, in the importance of the family. It's here that Oscar De La Hoya was raised.
Well, this is it, East Los Angeles. When everybody thinks of East Los Angeles, this is the place. Best place in the world. Neighborhood number one. Well, this is a gym where we started at. A lot of great memories here. A lot of boxing shows we had here. The support, my family, my mother, she was here cheering me on. And, you know, my father brought me at 6 years of age.
You know, my grandfather boxed, my father boxed, and it runs in the family, it's in the blood. We all love boxing, it's a great sport. My father would take me every day, never miss a day, push me, and it's something that I really stop and think, you know. Ooh. Gosh, you know, maybe if my father wasn't there, then what would I be? I wouldn't be nobody. We were poor, you know, I mean, we didn't have really nothing, and that's what really pushed me more to work hard and one day, hopefully, you know, have a big home and have everything. This is a lady here that made it all possible. She taught me everything. She's the one that guided me, you know. She's the one that was there with me, you know, when we had bad times, when it was good times, you know. She's everything to me. My family means a whole lot to me. I love my whole family. They're the ones that really support me the most. They're the ones that love me. They're the ones that really push Oscar De La Hoya. They motivate him to really do the best job possible out there.
We've got to take a commercial break. When we come back, the main event, Oscar De La Hoya, Frankie Avelar from beautiful Lake Tahoe. Don't go away. Welcome back to Lake Tahoe, Nevada. We're inside Caesars Tahoe Resort. And Oscar De La Hoya is just making his entrance into the ring. Frankie Avelar is already on the scene. And Alex Wallow, we've talked about personalities. Let's talk about what it's going to take to win this fight.
Well, in terms of strategy, Dan, from Oscar's point of view, he's made an easy transition to the pros. His style was really better suited to the pros than the amateurs because it is based on power. And Oscar says he loves the pros because he can take his time and put power in every punch. The one Achilles heel that Oscar may have as he moves up is in terms of mobility. He is not yet very good at cutting the ring off and moving around the ring. And he may be bothered by a guy who's got very, very good ring movement. Frankie Avelar is not that opponent. Frankie is a fairly immobile opponent. You see there, he is a super featherweight champion. That means he's a 130-pound champion. Dan, one interesting thing here is that this fight was made at 132 pounds, and Oscar actually weighed in at 131. The last time we saw him, if you remember, he weighed the heaviest he had for his career, which is 138. So they are now looking in terms of Oscar at going down and perhaps fighting for his first title fight at 130 pounds. The bottom line is Frankie Avelar will be fighting a couple of pounds above where he is most effective, and that cannot be good for him.
All right, Alex, you mentioned their weights. Let's go ahead and check the tail of the tape. And we will find out one thing for sure. Oscar De La Hoya is a tall lightweight at 5'9 and a quarter, only 20 years old, and an extensive reach advantage for De La Hoya. Let's go up now to our ring, and Michael Buffer has the ring announcements.
Incorporated presents 10 rounds of boxing in the lightweight division. The referee for this contest is Vic Draculich. And now, ladies and gentlemen, from Caesars Tahoe, let's get ready to rumble! Introducing first, fighting out of the red corner, wearing the red, white, and blue trunks, weighing in at 131 and one-half pounds. Fighting out of Las Vegas, Nevada, with a record of 15-3, 7 KOs, ladies and gentlemen, El Pistolero Frankie Avelar! And his opponent across the ring, fighting out of the blue corner, wearing the white trunks and weighing in at 131 pounds, from Montebello, California, undefeated with a record of 6-0, 5 KOs, the 1992 Olympic gold medal champion, the pride of East L.A., the golden boy, Oscar De La Hoya.
The rules for our fight today, It's a non-title fight, so the Nevada State Athletic Commission rules will apply. Scoring will be on the 10-point must system. The three knockdown rule is in effect. The standing eight is not. Only the referee may stop the bout, and a fighter can be saved by the bell, but only in the final round. And as you heard Michael Buffer say, Vic Draculich is our referee. Shaved off his beard, a different look for Vic, and the clean-shaven one is ready to get this thing started.
Small ring, Dan, 17-foot ring. And that's
as we had in the last De La Hoya fight when we had them out in San Diego. Back in February. Frankie Avelar in the striped shorts. Oscar De La Hoya in the all-white. Befitting his image, certainly. Both conventional right-handed fighters. Both good left hand by De La Hoya, caught Avelar on the forehead.
You see Frankie Avelar there trying to work the body. Oscar putting out some not full snap jabs.
Frankie Avelar, Alex, had some bold talk before this fight, actually predicting that he would knock De La Hoya out. De La Hoya has already signed to fight Troy Dorsey next month. And this really, this was a very personal thing to Avelar, who took offense to that, saying he's been overlooked.
I really like Frankie's attitude. He said, I see this fight as a first of a two-fight series. I'm going to beat him, and then we're going to come back and fight again, and I'll beat him again in a big money rematch.
Well, he certainly has the eye towards promotion. Let's see if he has the eye towards fisticuffs and being able to handle Oscar.
You see the latest endorsement deal of Oscar De La Hoya. Bum sports apparel there. That is not a comment on Oscar's ability. I think it's a strange kind of potential to be on boxing trunks.
See, they just got $1 million worth of publicity. Great combination by De La Hoya. Look at the fast hands. Oh, a solid left uppercut by De La Hoya.
Frankie Avelar is not letting his hands go. He's usually a fairly busy fighter.
We want to remind our ABC stations that we'll be taking a station break at the end of this round. The crisper punches have been landed by Oscar De La Hoya in the first 2 minutes of this fight.
And obviously Oscar being very, very patient. He has not come out here as Jeremy Williams did looking for a quick knockout. He is taking his time. Last fight, he went the full eight-round distance, the first non-knockout in his pro career.
Ooh. Another good punch by De La Hoya. That was against Mike Grable. Oh, another digging left hand. De La Hoya's punches are landing solid.
And Frankie Avelar is kicked into a full survival mode.
Yes.
He is not throwing punches.
Well, again, Alex, some more punches at De La Hoya. We commented about Oscar before. Look at that lethal shot combination. Alex, he is a huge lightweight at over 5'9".
He's a bigger 132-31 pounder today. He looks a little bit drawn to me, but so far, that seemed to affect him at all.
We'll return after a word from our ABC stations. The end of the first.
I just thought he was pacing himself. Yeah. Now, he won eight his last fight, so you wouldn't think that I made that point in the fight. No.
That's a good shot.
I'm getting lousy corner audio from Blue. The fish pole is not even close to being where it is. I just don't know why we can't. It's also blocking our handheld camera, but
here we go, the start of the second round on our Quaker State Professional Boxing Series, and Frankie Avelar fights back, and he lands some good solid shots to the body.
And two good right hands to the head. It seemed to be that Oscar went funny, but it definitely got Oscar's attention.
Species were both in the round one.
Oh, there was no way that he could take the shots he took in round one for more than five or six rounds maximum. Frankie Avelar has opened up here with a real flurry in the second round.
That really can only be good for Oscar De La Hoya. I mean, he needs to have opponents of 12 punches like Frankie's trying to do right now.
There's a good right to the side, then he came back with a left
a talented prospect against opponents who are good enough to provide a valuable learning experience, but not good enough to beat your guy. British promoter Mickey Duff's phrase, capable but not dangerous. And I think that's what Frankie Avalon is into right now.
Look at that left hand by De La Hoya. You can see it coming. He landed about 10 consecutive hard punches just the way it happened in the first round.
Walk to me, Ben.
And he drops Avalon with a big left hand.
For the first time in Frankie Avalon's 18-fight pro career.
And now Frankie's got to be smart here in the last minute of the second round.
Frankie's gone from being aggressive in the first 30 seconds of this round back into the survival mode.
Jab, good body shot combination, but look at that. Luckily, most of those landed on Avalon's shoulder. Regained his feet and his composure inside the final 10 seconds of the second round, and we're going to stay here between commercials and take a look at the knockdown. Stay here between rounds.
Good work by Oscar De La Hoya. There you see Eddie Mustafa Muhammad, the former Eddie the Flame Gregory, sitting Frankie Avalar down there.
Eddie,
a former light heavyweight
champion.
Hands up
more. You're looking over your gloves. Hide behind the glove, Frankie, and roll and relax. All right? The up jabs working perfect. Don't stop doing that. And don't wait for
a real talented trainer. Let's take a look at the knockdown. Straight jab, right hand missed, but that inside left, put your punches together. Sometimes the punches don't have to land to set your man up.
It was kind of a cross, Alex, between a hook and an uppercut.
And an uppercut, yeah.
It was on the dot, right on the 45 degree.
Oscar's very left hand oriented. You see here again, a good combination later in the round.
Methodical is the only way to describe the approach of Oscar De La Hoya.
All right. Come on, champ. Let's go, baby. He shot his leg.
The eyes, they bear down. We talked at the top of the show about, with all the distractions and the whirlwind of activities around him, how he's able to maintain his focus on his training and his boxing. There's a good look at it right there.
Let's go, Frankie. Go straight on it.
Stiff left hand. De La Hoya, that was just a solid jab. And look at the concentration. To sit and talk with Oscar De La Hoya is to talk to the meekest, most mild-mannered, most civilized and gentlemanly young person you could find. And that snarl you see on his face in the ring, Alex, is a complete 180.
Yeah, he burns. I mean, you can see it in his eyes. They're not Duran's eyes. I mean, they're not that kind of intensity. Nobody else had what Duran had in recent memory. But he's in focused, intense, complaining about a butt there. Wanted to touch gloves. Frankie's too busy holding his hands up trying to protect his chin.
As Frankie Avalon goes down.
Siete.
I'm not sure he's going
to. Ocho.
Well,
okay.
He waits till the last minute.
What do we get?
I admire Victor Coolidge's Spanish. And give him the count.
The second knockdown of the fight. And Oscar De La Hoya now zeroes in.
Frankie said before the fight, he's all left hand. All I have to do is move to my left to stay away from it. It's easier said than done.
And there's more than just the left hand. But when you listen to the sound that De La Hoya's punches make when they land, there is an audible difference between the two.
You know, Dan, it's interesting to see Oscar at this weight. He weighs 131 pounds, as we said, very light for him. He's looking to see how he feels to go down to 130. But he's this gaunt and this tight at the weight, he really does begin to remind you a little bit, not quite as tall, but of Arguello, Alexis Arguello, who was one of his idols. He's got the same kind of stalking about him, the same intensity.
Look at the fast hands by De La Hoya and Frank Avelar to his credit fights back.
Go!
No rollover here in Frankie Avelar.
Absolutely to his credit and to Oscar De La Hoya's benefit, as we said. He needs these kind of fights as learning experiences. Needs to learn how to finish a man when he had him hurt, as he did in the last round.
But when you're watching this at home, and we're watching this from ringside, it looks like these two are two weight classes apart.
Well, actually, they are. I mean, you know, I mean, except they both are 131.
Yeah.
But the point is they come from different weight classes. And you got one man, Frankie Avelar, on the right, coming up from 130, and Oscar De La Hoya coming down from lightweight 135.
And actually, they come into this fight, Avelar weighing a half pound more. Figure it out.
Did you ever find that Jeremy Williams stuff? I know it's tough in the middle of all this. Can anybody in there hear the blue corner when you isolate it?
Sigue trabajando, mi gente. Está lastimado del primer round. Okay, sigue trabajando como está. Nomás necesita tiempo. Okay?
Let me see. Let me see it again. I still don't understand what he did. Did he roll off the punch roll off the shoulder? Slow. Go slow.
Okay. Put it down.
Okay,
go.
Siga trabajando. Está muy bien. Ya está lastimado.
Let's go.
Yeah, but if you look at
it. Get out of here.
The beginning of the fourth round from Lake Tahoe, Nevada, on our Quaker State Professional Boxing Series. Dan Dierdorf, along with Alex Swallow, ringside from Caesars Tahoe. Oscar De La Hoya there on the left in the white trunks. Frankie Avelar wearing the red, white, and blue.
Let's go!
Frankie Avelar has been down twice in the second and the third round. Oscar De La Hoya has been methodical in his approach to this fight.
Methodical and very, very patient. And there might be some who find fault with the fact that Oscar did not jump in his man when he had him hurt. Down twice.
That second left time. Hand by Avelar was low. Time. The warning by referee Vic Draculich.
Vic says, don't be. In Frankie's mind, you're finished. A little bit of pitch here, will you?
That warning, the least of Frankie Avalar's problems.
Yeah. Vic said, second and last time, meaning next time he take a point away, I don't think Frankie's concerned.
Oscar De La Hoya, two separate occasions in this fight, has unleashed 8 to 10 punch combinations.
Hands up!
This is just falling punches by De La Hoya. I don't understand what he's doing here, Alex. He's just rat-a-tat-tatting.
Hands up!
He's throwing punches. You see, this is Oscar for the amateurs. This is not really smart. Oscar said the thing he likes about the pros, well, maybe he's just trying to low break it down and let go punches like that.
Obviously, Oscar has two speeds. Down goes Avelar again, and that might be it.
4, 5, 6, 7.
Frankie's going to get up.
What the?
He made it.
You all right? I want you to walk to me.
Frankie Avelar. Vic Draculich seriously considering stopping this fight. And I'm not so sure he should have. Yeah. There it goes. Oscar De La Hoya remains undefeated, moves to 7-0. Six of them by knockout, and a game performance by Frankie Avelar. He got up, he tried to continue, and Vic Draculich, the referee, I think wisely stopped this fight. This kid is good.
Let's take a look, Dan, at the combination against the ropes that put Frankie down. Oscar, remember, had been pity-patting, but here he stepped it up, as you pointed out. He kicked into the second speed. Frankie just had no place to go except the canvas. He took a count of 9.5, got up, nodded yes to the referee. The referee, Vic Draculich, let me point out one thing that happened there. Watch what happens here. Let this play through, if you would. He begs him, he lets Frankie walk to him. Dan, if you remember, and then Oscar move in, and then Vic, after a series of punches, accurate punches, Vic Draculich steps in, the referee, and stops the fight. Dan, you remember...
I don't want to be right on top of that.
Okay, we're winding things down here at ringside. And Alex, on the undercard today, we had a scheduled 6-round heavyweight bout. Only lasted 2 as Jeremy Williams knocked out Danelle Nicholson.
A rare treat, Dan. 2 outstanding, undefeated. We didn't know if they were outstanding yet. Heavyweight prospects. The thing that impressed me about Jeremy Williams, the winner, was this action here from the first round. Boom. Jeremy's on the left. He walked into a big right hand from Danelle Nicholson. With his back to you, but he survived that. He took that punch, he came back, and then in round 2, he knocked his man down early and then finished it here. Action late in round 2. Jeremy Williams with his back to you. That big uppercut, the major damage, that right on the point of the chin, and then this left hand, Danelle Nicholson went face down to the canvas, and the referee stopped it. An impressive performance by Jeremy Williams. Some people thought that he was being rushed into that fight.
All right, speaking of impressive performances, let's move to what we saw in the main event with Oscar De La Hoya, as he had a 4th-round knockout, but we're going to pick up the action, Alex, here in the 2nd round.
Yeah, and this was the first time that Oscar, who paces himself, is very patient, took a left hand there. I'm sorry, that's Frankie Avelar. Oscar with his back to you. Frankie Avelar, the opponent, down from a left hand, an inside left hand. More of the same in round 3. Oscar measuring on the right of your screen with the left, and boom, the right comes over. Frankie Avelar, delayed reaction, draped on the ropes. And now a 4th-round knockdown, the 3rd knockdown of the fight. Frankie Avelar looking for a place to go, back on the ropes. Oscar all over him, letting both hands go. Frankie went down. He got up and beat the count, but the referee wisely stopped it after a few punches. Oscar, congratulations first. This was your first time as a pro, Oscar, down as low as 131. Obviously, you carried the weight well enough to win the fight. How did you feel at the weight?
I felt great. I felt stronger. I felt faster. I felt light up in the ring. And we wanted to see how we would feel at this weight. And people were saying, you know, gosh, it's too low for you. You know, you're going to feel weak up there. But I felt just stronger as I, you know, would be, and maybe 140, you know.
Right. Oscar, are you waiting for a test? He was totally outgunned today. Are you anxious to have some kind of test to find out how good you are?
You know, all my opponents are tests, but the fact that we train so hard up in the ring, we train in the gym and we go to the mountains and train up there, we're in good shape. We're ready for a fight always. They seem so easy, but they're really tough. They're good tests. And
quickly, Oscar, I'm sorry to interrupt. I just want to know quickly, when do you expect to fight for the title?
Hopefully by the end of this year. I'm not sure what month, but hopefully by the end of this year.
Thanks very much, Oscar. Okay. You'll only be a pro November, Dan, if he fights that quickly. He turned pro November of last year.
Okay, congratulations, Oscar, and thanks to our ABC crew. For Alex Wallow, I'm Dan Dierdorf. Thanks for being with us, everybody. So long from Lake Tahoe.